breezes, Saints.
First opened back in 1975. There's a look inside the iconic Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Tennessee Titans and the New Orleans Saints. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 20. Michigan man, Darius Jackson on the carry. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line.
Brandon, after last week, we went over 200 yards. Looks like the hot tub, cold tub, whatever he did, it worked pretty well.
Much chatter about that performance. Rightfully so, AFC Offensive Player of the Week. Second down. Here's Newton. Trying to get it to Jackson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Kenny Vaccaro. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And the defense could not have written a much better script than that. First drive, pick six.
The offense never got a chance to really get oiled up there, did they? But the defense, they certainly got in gear. What a big-time play and a great way for them to start.
And now the offense, they've got to turn things around and figure this out because your backs are on the ground real quickly.
Yeah, usually when you're starting the game getting the ball, 0-0 is the only score you're worried about. Now the second time you get it, you're already down a touchdown.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Well, now they'll try the end around. And he's got some space here. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
First play of the drive, a first down run. Well, that sets you up for whichever way you want to go. Do you come right back and run the football again because you've got them on their heels? Or do you play chess match with them? Break tendency and go play action and go for the big shot.
Dancing to his left. Uncorks one. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. I know it's an emotional game, Charles. You can't do that.
And when you get into your film sessions and you argue your case with your coaches, that's exactly what they say at the end. You just can't do it. It costs your team.
So now it's first and goal. This is Jackson, and he gets halfway home from the 4 down to the 2-yard line. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here. This close, sneak it.
I don't think you even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
Second and goal from the 2-yard line. They run again with Jackson, and he will take this one in for a Titans touchdown. A great play there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Breeze to throw on second down. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage, and that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcommit running in that direction. Then he cuts back up inside you into the middle of the field. That's what we just saw there for a nice pickup.
He's going to find his running back. It's complete. Call it a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll make it a second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Now a handoff here to his running back, and he's going to take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on third and six. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on second down. Now Breeze on third down. And this is going to be incomplete. But not to get too overcritical there, because he knows what he's doing, but his shoulders looked a little off kilter there when he threw that.
I don't think you're being overly critical there. You're just analyzing it, and he gets those shoulders right. That pass will go from incomplete to complete.
And he was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. Almost outkicked his coverage there. 48-yard punt, but 10 on the return. And the Titans will be backed up deep to begin the drive as they take over first and 10. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. And a movement there coming from the middle of the line.
And you understand he wants to get off the ball quickly, but the ball's right in front of him. He has to watch it move first.
They'll run it with Jackson. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. Call it a gain of 4. Leaves him with options here on second and just a yard.
Only 4 yards on that gain, but, you know, a lot of people would say that's like getting 9 in normal circumstances since this was first and 5.
Yeah, now your playbook's wide open here, second and very short.
Yeah, I still don't think that you can count it in the stats that way at contract time.
No, no, it still goes down as 4, not okay. 9. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here. They fake the give, Newton. And an alley to run. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Newton able to use those legs and get past the marker to pick up the first.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
First down, it's Newton. Being chased out left. Bringing it in, Jackson left side. A very solid gain of 27. First catch of this game, a big one. Of course, he had the big performance last week when he was AFC Offensive Player of the Week.
Yeah, but that was so last week, wasn't it? I mean, look at what he's doing now. I think he's trying to exceed what he did in that game and continue to ascend in this season.
On the ground, this is Jackson. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. And the offense moving in the wrong direction here now as they face a second and 12. To throw is Newton. And he's going to go out of bounds at the 30-yard line. 13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. So here we go, first and 10 now. Jackson, and running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. So second and 10 here. Georgia Southern man, this is Jarek McKinnon. About 3 yards there to the 27.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Here's play number 7 on the drive. This is 3rd and 7. A shotgun snap for Newton. He's going to go up top for the... Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then...
Under a heavy rush and down he goes.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast and a big sack. Second down, here's Breeze. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by the USC man, Adoree Jackson.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Now a handoff as they run left side. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
Came out in a power set, but that only served to put more men in the box. And guess what? If you're going to do that, you've got to win up front, right? Your offensive guys have got to beat the defenders. They lost all leverage on that play.
Here's Newton now on second down. To the right side, complete to Taylor. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
So third and five, defensively expecting pass. They've got six DBs out there. From the gun, here's Newton. The swing pass caught, and he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Mason Schreck, his first touchdown on the year. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. It's good, and it is now 21-7. Catanzaro out now as he'll kick this one away. No return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now, and I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try to move the football.
And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-arm guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
Oh, nearly picked. Almost intercepted, but he couldn't hang on, and it's third down.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Breeze to throw on third and one. Over the middle, complete. It's Hanson. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first. Now a play fake here on first down. Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33, and his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They go play action here on first down. And the Saints' pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
To throw on second down is Newton. Throw left side complete to Sharp. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Throwing on third down, Newton. Eluding the pressure right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
An update now from Oakland. Now you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. And we'll keep you abreast of how that one shakes out. And they're this one across the 35. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
On play action, now Breeze. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Logan Ryan. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Make it back-to-back weeks now with a pick six for him. He had one a week ago.
Talk about being in the groove, and what are the odds of what we're seeing right here? You don't see it happen very often. Listen, if you get a pick six in a season, it's been a big year, let alone back-to-back weeks. I'll tell you this, I wouldn't play cards against this guy in the locker room.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Here's Breeze. Left side and caught by Flaner. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
A minute 59 to go in the first half. We're back to New Orleans after this. On first down, Breeze. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
But one thing that I'd like defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Back to the air on second down. It's Breeze. Over the middle, open is Thomas. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. So the offense has it first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that'll lead here to a third down. Throw. And he's got Snead. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
Now Breeze throwing on second down. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Now the Saints will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. This offense so far on third down, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. They're looking at a third and goal here. To throw, it's Breeze. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield. But when push came to shove, they stood their ground. And now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
And Lutz's kick is good. Around the NFL, we've got a second quarter score. And it's a big-time advantage for the Browns. They just scored again, pouring it on. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And the Titans getting set to go. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Yards. They take him down at the 26. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down.
Yeah, that was a safety that came through and made the play, but there's no doubt in my mind he hits like a linebacker, and we see a lot of that in today's NFL, don't we?
And that time we do indeed. A big hit for a loss. Here's Newton trying to lay one up deep. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. We have hit halftime. Still 2 more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this is a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. They'll run it now out of the gun. Pushing forward for 3 up to the 48.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
Shotgun now for Breeze. Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down. And there they bring pressure from the inside, and they get home.
Yeah, hard to block everyone, isn't it? And on this play, someone did not get blocked. He's the one who got home.
Third and long now after the sack of Breeze, and the Saints up against it here. Breeze now to throw. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a 4th pick of the game. And now 4th down. Here's Thomas Morstead now. On for his 2nd punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away. And boy, it's another boomer. This is taken at the 10. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the offense will come back out deep in their own territory. The Titans offense gears up for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
for the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done.
In motion left is Sharp. Now they'll run it on the toss. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but yeah, from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long. The Titans on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12. Out of the gun, Newton. A dump down to McKinnon. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. They do get 12, but they'll be marked short. And that leads to a fourth down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a checkdown. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. And I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half. The Saints coming out now to take the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times.
It got his man complete. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best player out on the field. You still carry that supreme arrogance with you and continue to fire the ball. I've seen guys have games like this, and this is where you find out if you're great or not. Can you overcome some interceptions and still lead your team to victory?
On first and 10, here's Breeze. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by the linebacker, Avery Williamson. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. That's now a second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. Tajay Sharp, the intended receiver, and it's second down. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
He takes this for 3 to the 29.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in the expected passing situation.
On third down, Newton. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
The best receivers we know always tease their quarterbacks to, hey, no matter what you do, you cannot overthrow me. Well, guess what? That's exactly what happened on that play. Normally, they time it up pretty well, but on that one, he just overshot him.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. Now a hit and a loose football, and they will take over at the 26-yard line.
It's been a struggle all game for them on offense. This was a chance to maybe provide a little bit of a spark with a punt return. Unfortunately, that spark got doused.
Yeah, and you call special teams the third phase, but you see here it can be the first phase sometimes.
That is so true, right? It can ignite it one way or the other. Oh, boy, that didn't help them at all.
Letting one go deep for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Now they needed a break. They needed to make a play here in the third quarter. Defensively, they did that. Now they got to go quickly and get some points on the board.
And the best part is that they made their own break, taking the ball away. Now they just look at their offense and saying, guys,
let's go.
Come on, capitalize on this one.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. A good pickup there on first as the screen pass gets him 8.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Breeze to throw on second down. And he's got it over the middle. Fleener. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Breeze now on first down. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Throwing on first down is Breeze. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Jurrell Casey in there to get him, and that's sack number 8 for him on the year. On second down, here's Breeze. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete.
Brandon, at least there's one bright side to that incompletion.
What's that?
It wasn't an interception.
Wow. You're a nice guy. That was kind of savage. But correct. No pick, just incomplete that time.
On third and long, it's Breeze. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's going to be out of bounds down inside the 20. It's a pickup of 13, but they're still a bit short, and it'll be fourth down. On fourth down, off goes Drew Brees, and on comes the Saints kicker Will Lutz for the field goal attempt. From the right hash, this from 33. And Lutz puts this one through. And that'll get the deficit down to 15. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
This fielded a few yards into the end zone. Spinning past him. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Out come the Titans now.
This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, but you can take the spirit away from another team, that their drive and will to come back and win can be taken with another score right here.
Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're teetering right there on the brink, aren't they?
Back now here live in New Orleans. It's the Titans. They've got the football. They'll be looking to extend their lead here as we begin the fourth quarter. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Here's Newton now on second down. And he's taken down here by the Saints. Well, that was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
The Titans on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 14. gun. Here's Newton. And he finds his target. It's Sharp. And they'll get it all the way out near midfield to the 45. A big third down conversion with a gain of 28. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Newton on first down. Screen play, McKinnon. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. The first down screen pass, good for five.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
From the 50, Newton. And that is incomplete. Corey Davis, the intended receiver, third down here.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete.
Newton throwing again. Hard throw, incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
Barry on to punt as he gets this one away. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get six and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. And incomplete on the deep ball. Trying to get it to Willie Snead there. And now it's second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield.
Breeze going to throw. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he's going to be stopped dead in his tracks right around the 26. 6 yards on the pickup, and they're going to have a third down. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Side by Snead. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Now a play fake here on first down. It's complete. Flater, right side. And oh, he coughed it up. It's picked up by the Titans.
Brandon, I don't want to violate any of our broadcasting rules by declaring a game over before it's over. But that one, that puts them in real jeopardy there.
Absolutely. It was a two-possession game. It is a two-possession game at this stage in the fourth. They needed points out of that drive.
And obviously now, no chance at all to get those points that they so desperately needed.
They go play action here on first down. And he's going to be swallowed up. Sacked back at the 45-yard line. Nick Fairley able to use that strength and get him for a loss of two.
And they're behind the sticks here a bit now, dealing with a second and 12.
Now a handoff looking right. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. It'll be a loss of one, and it's going to be third down and a ways to go here. Third and 14.
Shotgun snap for Newton.
And that is incomplete.
This defense could use some more of these types of plays. How about him reading it, driving on the football, and he's right there for the pass breakup.
Here's Jordan Berry now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. And now the Saints get set to trot out there. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, yeah. Because you're exactly
you
right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
23 yards on the play. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
And incomplete.
Oh, he caught it. Just couldn't get the feet down. Couldn't get that toe tap sequence, right? I was ready to call him tippy toes if that one was completed.
To the air on second down. It's Breeze. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. On first down, Breeze. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Hanson. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. Breeze now on first down. And brought in here by Fleener. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like...
And this is caught. It's the tight end Fleener for the Saints touchdown. Kobe Fleener, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Saints get a bit closer. And it's good. So that will get them back within one score. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. The Titan offense now working their way back onto the field. Certainly want to avoid what they had to do last possession. That was punt the football because this game's starting to tighten up.
In a basketball sense, you'd think about taking a little bit of the air out of the ball, right? Maybe milk some clock, limit the possessions. In this case, they might want to do the same thing but control the game offensively. Put together some first downs, put together a drive, and keep it away from them.
Here's Newton. Throw left side complete to Sharp. And now, defensively, they're going to burn their first timeout. Remember, they get an extra time built in coming up here shortly at the two-minute warning. So they're leading. They have possession of the football, and certainly this is where they just want to milk the clock. On second down, here's Newton. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. And his defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. The offense on third down tonight, they've converted three times and eight chances. They're looking at third and a few inches. Oh, a design run for their wideout. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. And now a timeout taken here defensively with 2:07 remaining. So they'll also have the stop coming up at the two-minute warning. Time is starting to run out, really becoming a factor. We'll see if the defense can get the stop they need to get the ball back to the offense. Toss play to McKinnon.
There he goes, left side. Past the 20. Touchdown, Titans. Jerick McKinnon, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drop.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the linebacker, Avery Williamson. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line. Both defenses have had their struggles, but they've been good enough to get them this lead and another nice play there to help preserve the lead.
It's been a game of punch-counterpunch, hasn't it, all throughout. But this time, the big swing was taken, and it didn't land. Nice play by them on defense.
It'll wind up being a loss of two, and that'll make it second and 12. A handoff as they run the counter play, and hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose, and his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line.
Well, I'm guessing that on the sidelines, there might be a few words said about that mistake there, but I don't think it's going to hurt them in the long run. They're still going to get out of here with a win.
Yeah, they got the two-score cushion, but you know what coaches say, Charles? Finish strong.
Finish the game out the way it's supposed to be played. In fact, coaches might be secretly happy, gives them a chance to do a little extra coaching next week.
Now after the fumble recovery, it's Breeze. Sneed's got it. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary.
He's got it at the 15. And he'll take it down deep into Tennessee territory. A big-time play there for New Orleans. 47 yards. Shift together here from the D-line. Throwing now is Breeze. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Kobe Flaner, the tight end, his intended target. That'll bring up second down.
So this is what happens when you throw interceptions, that confident veneer that you have. Gets chipped away a little bit. Maybe a little bit gun-shy throwing it around.
Yeah, under-throwing him there, and you're right. Those interceptions may be in the back of his mind. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Now, Breeze again. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked by Kevin Byard, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Just a little bit of a rough stretch. 6 interceptions now in these last 2 weeks combined.
I know the easy thing is to go back to mechanics, footwork, things of that nature. I'm also wondering, is he getting fooled by what he's seeing on defense? Has the scouting report changed? Are they showing him things different than what he expected? For the second week in a row, he's throwing it to the guys in the wrong color shirts.
Yeah, he better figure, whatever the reason is, he better figure it out. Yardage on the play, back at his own 19-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 11. Oh,
McKinnon. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. Here's Jordan Berry now, standing right on his own 5-yard line. It's taken on the... Now a hit and a loose football. It's picked up by the Titans. And he takes it in for the score on the game's final play. So it doesn't affect the outcome, but a little whipped cream on top to their ending.
Or as our friends in Bayou Country would say, that's a little lanyap, a little extra on top.
It's up and good, and they add one more to what will wind up a fairly lopsided.
I look up, so many.
Oh my God.
So many.
I done made sacrifices.
I.
So many sacrifices.
Straight up.
I done gave up so much free time, knowing time ain't free.
Free.
I sacrificed it. My girl showed me love, she know I made sacrifices. And if it's real love, then you make sacrifices. To get ahead, man, you gotta make sacrifices. That's how hungry my appetite is. Yeah.
What you telling me? I sense the jealousy. I got telepathy. I got the recipe. I got the streets and I don't got no felony. Forward thinking, yeah, my mind is ahead of me. Mama said it's gonna be whatever you let it be. It's some homies I grew up with that's dead to me. It's some...